Moving on to the next cell organelles. In the previous video, we had done about cell organelles. Today, I am taking up the next cell organelle, that is endoplasmic reticulum. Whatever I am telling you, beta, that much is sufficient for you. So, just prepare this much for you as of now. Now, we are going to study about endoplasmic reticulum, ER. What do you call it in short? ER. Endoplasmic reticulum, in short, it is called as ER. What is it? How does it look like? It's actually a network of tiny tube-like structures which are found in the cytoplasm. Imagine a cell, you know the cytoplasm. Now there are tube-like structures. These tube-like are not only one, it's a network of tube-like structures. Imagine there are a lot of tube-like structures forming a network in the cytoplasm. This network of tube-like structures in the cytoplasm is what we call as endoplasmic reticulum. What is it called? Endoplasmic reticulum. Now this endoplasmic reticulum, it divides the intracellular space. What is intracellular space? The space between two cells is what we call as intracellular space. Now because they are tube-like structures, they are scattered all over the cytoplasm. So these endoplasmic reticulums lying here and there, they divide the intracellular space into two compartments, two sections. What is intracellular space? The space between two cells. So this space between two cells, because of the presence of endoplasmic reticulum, is differentiated into two compartments. That part which comes inside the endoplasmic reticulum. Obviously, that some part of the cytoplasm is coming inside the endoplasmic reticulum. That compartment which is inside the endoplasmic reticulum is called the luminal compartment. L-U-M-I-N-A-L, luminal compartment. Okay? And the one which is outside the ER, that means the cytoplasm part. That is what we call as the extra lumina part. Extra lumina. Now we have cytoplasm. Inside the cytoplasm, we have these tube-like structures, endoplasmic reticulum. So that space, that part of the intracellular space which is inside the ER is called the laminal compartment, luminal compartment, L-U-M-I-N-A-L, luminal compartment. And the one which is outside the ER, that is the cytoplasm, is what we call as the extra lumina. So what are the two compartments? Luminal inside the ER and extra lumina outside. We know that sometimes ribosomes are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. That endoplasmic reticulum which has ribosome on its surface is called RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. And if there are no ribosomes present, then the surface of ER is smooth and we call it as SER, that is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now this RER, you know, rough endoplasmic reticulum, this is mainly found in cells which are involved in protein synthesis. Obviously we have ribosomes present in it and ribosomes are involved in protein synthesis. So RER is mainly found in those cells which are involved in protein synthesis. They are very extensive, continuous outer membrane and they are connected to the outer membrane of the nucleus. Now these RERs are very extensive networks and they are connected to the outer membrane of the nucleus. Now moving on to SER. SER is a major site for synthesis of lipids. RER was mainly involved in protein synthesis. SER is the major site where lipids are synthesized. What are synthesized as lipids? In animal cells, what is synthesized is lipid-like steroidal hormones. Some kind of hormones which are known as steroidal hormones. So those which have ribosomes are RER, those which do not have ribosomes are SER. RER is involved in protein synthesis. And in SER, SER is a major site of synthesis of lipids and steroidal hormones when we talk about animals. Moving on to the next cell organelle, that is Golgi apparatus. It was Cavanaugh-Golgi who first observed them lying close to the nucleus. That is why we call them as Golgi apparatus. What is Golgi apparatus? Many flat disc-shaped sacs. They are sac-like structures which are flat and shaped like a disc. So flat disc-shaped sacs are what we call as cisternae. What are these called as? Cisternae. Now what are Golgi apparatus consist of? Golgi apparatus is not one thing, beta. Golgi apparatus consists of all those flat disc-shaped sacs which are known as cisternae. They may be 0.5 to 1 micrometers in diameter. They are small, how much? 0.5 to 1 micrometers in diameter. And these flat disc-shaped sacs are what we call as cisternae. They are stocked parallel to each other. A number of cisternae are stocked parallel to each other. Is it okay? Near the nucleus, they are arranged in a concentric manner. Normally they are stacked parallel to each other, but if you go closer to the nucleus, you will find that near the nucleus they arrange in a concentric manner. They have two phases. We have a cis phase and we have a trans phase. Okay, the cis phase is known as the convex phase and the trans phase is also known as the concave phase. So we have two phases, the distinct phase, that is the convex phase or the cis phase, and the trans phase or the concave phase. So this cis phase and trans phase are different phases, but remember that they are interconnected with each other. What are cis and trans phase? See, that end from where the substances enter from the ER. Now this Golgi apparatus will receive substances from the endoplasmic reticulum. So that end of the Golgi apparatus, that end, that mouth of the Golgi apparatus, from where the substances will enter from the endoplasmic reticulum is called as a cis phase, CIS, cis phase, or it is known as the convex phase. Is it okay for everybody? So this is the receiving phase. This is the receiving phase of vesicles. It receives from the endoplasmic, it receives the vesicles from the endoplasmic reticulum. From the endoplasmic reticulum, vesicles will enter the Golgi apparatus. They will enter from that end, which is known as the receiving end, or that is known as the cis end, CIS, cis phase, or it is also known as the convex phase. Now, once the Golgi apparatus receives these vesicles, okay, they are received from the cis phase, I told you, then they contain some proteins, and then after taking these proteins, they move on from the other phase of the Golgi apparatus, which is known as the trans phase, or it is also known as the convex phase. So the receiving side is known as the cis phase, CIS, and the exit side from where the vesicles are going to go out of the endoplasmic reticulum, out of the Golgi apparatus, is what we call as the trans phase. The main function of Golgi apparatus is packaging materials. Is it okay? It packages the materials which have to be delivered. Now materials to be packaged in the form of vesicles come from where? They come from the endoplasmic reticulum. So these materials which come from the endoplasmic reticulums, they enter from the cis phase, I told you, and then they move out from the trans phase. That is why you will always find that the Golgi apparatus lies always very close to the endoplasmic reticulum, because it receives the vesicles from where? From endoplasmic reticulum. A number of proteins are synthesized by ribosomes in the ER, and these are modified in the Golgi apparatus. Now in the ER, I'm especially talking about RER, some proteins are synthesized. These proteins from the endoplasmic reticulum, they are transferred to the Golgi apparatus. Remember the receiving phase? That was the cis phase. These proteins are then modified inside the Golgi apparatus, and then they are released to other parts through the other phase, that is the exit phase, which is also known as the trans phase. Golgi apparatus are also important sites for the formation of glycoproteins and glycolipids. Formation two things, glycoproteins and glycolipids. The main function of Golgi apparatus is it receives vesicles and proteins from endoplasmic reticulum, modifies them, and then it transfers it to other parts to the other phase, which is known as the trans phase or the exit phase. So in this video, we have done a little about endoplasmic reticulum and about the Golgi apparatus. Thank you.